Oh, my baby mush mush. My baby mush mush mushy mushy mushy. Hey, little sloth, it's me. And in case you don't know, my kitty loves to be smushed. When I smush her, she purrs louder. That's why we call her Miss Kitty Mush Mushy, because the more I smush her, the more she purrs and gets excited. So watch this. So listen really closely. I love Miss Kitty. I love Miss Kitty. I love Miss Kitty Mush Mush. I'm so full. She's helping me digest Miss Kitty Mush Mush.
Hey, little sloths, it's me, Nick Avocado. Avocado, I'm back home. Wait, we're not gonna do the song yet until the food arrives. I follow my Instagram at Nick Avocado Avocado, and if you do, I might just follow you back. The food arrives. I'm watching the little car right now. Beep, 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 on Postmates. Thanks, Postmates, who tweeted me and got my thing all fixed, because before they were charging me when I already paid for the free delivery month plan as a whatever. So anyways, thank you for the, okay. We are doing three things which don't really go together, but I'm craving crunchy fried chicken, and I've done KFC, I've done Buffalo Wild Wings, I'm doing something different that I haven't done before for a long time. So we're gonna do crunchy, super crispy Popeyes. Greasy, hopefully it's greasy. I got half spicy, half regular. Extra crispy, and I got some Cajun fries with some deep fried shrimp. That's on the way. I'm also gonna pair it with some Cheetos. Now, I really like Takis more, but I do care about your view, your viewing pleasure. I care about what you see, okay? I want you to experience something wonderful when you watch my videos, because a lot of you watch me when you're starving. You're on your diets. Boo-hoo, sad, too bad for you. I would never want to be on your diets. I eat for you. A lot of you eat air as you watch this. So since I just did Takis a few days ago, I'm not going to do we're going to do Cheetos. And on the stove right now is my creamy Alfredo pasta noodles. I have fettuccine Alfredo with fettuccine noodles. And I chopped up some garlic. I put some nutmeg in there. And I also added some mozzarella cheese. So the car is halfway here. I'm gonna go to the kitchen and get my stuff. Get the tray, get my noodles, get this ready. And we're gonna bring the Popeyes and we're gonna eat right away where it's still crispy and hot. Hot and steamy. Please remind me to sing my song. I'm not gonna do it yet because the food's not here. So anyways, I get excited. I'm so excited. Also, Orland's not here. Orland's gone for 2 days, so I have the house to myself and Miss Kitty, oh my. And it's really sad, literally, I miss him already. And we were just fighting yesterday about something so stupid. It's like one of those things you can't live with. It was one of those days where it's like, I can't live with you. I can't live with you. And well, that's not the reason he's gone, trust me. But it's one of those things you can't live with them, can't live without them. He left, and literally, he's like, baby, I miss you. I'm like, baby, I miss you too. And I'm like, heart, it's nice to have these breaks. This, ow, nice and steamy. I'm back home, shoo-be-doo, I'm home. Let's get everything out of the box, then I'll sing. Everyone's waiting for my song. Someone left a comment saying, I want to see you do a music. That ice cream truck with the copyright music is going to make me really mad in a minute. I'm about to blow my kettle top off. My Postmates lady was really nice. Yeah, I'm gonna do the I'm Back Home Shibidu song when I'm done. People are saying in the comments that I should do like an official music video. Shh. Okay, good. It was playing in my head that I still, you know when you hear a song and the song turns off, yet you still think you're hearing it because it's playing in your head over and over? Wow, they gave me a lot of sauces. Thank you. The lady was so nice too. She's gonna get a nice big tip. Always tip your driver. That's what you do. If you go out to restaurants, I was reading a post by one of my friends who said, if you can't afford to tip, don't go out at all. I kind of agree with that. That's the experience. You're being served and cleaned after. All right, so this is a lot of food. Oh my God. So I got 4 pieces of spicy, 4, ouch. That's hot, that pasta. And 4 pieces of plain. Everything is still hot and steamy, and hopefully it's crispy. What's in here? This is like Thanksgiving or Christmas opening boxes. She said, you know when you go on Postmates, it's not exactly the same. Oh, look at that. That's so cute. My biscuits, my Cajun fries, and my popcorn shrimp. She even called me to, like, clarify it. She's like, some people press the wrong buttons and they get sad. She's going above and beyond. Oh, wow. I got all these french fries? Wow. Okay. And then what's in here? She was so cute. She said she works for DoorDash, too. And this is Postmates. I got biscuits. All right, we have everything here. We have my Cheetos. I'm back home. Shoo-be-doo, I'm home. Hello, I'm back home. Shoo-be-doo, I'm home. Hello, and this is hot and steamy, 'cause we're eating Popeyes with Alfredo. Yeah. Grab some food. It's time to feast. Are you ready? Let's go. Let's begin the show. I'm back home, shooby-doo. And shout out to my sponsor, the coldest water. Nice ice cold water, cute little container. They have lots of different sizes, you guys know, because I drink these all the time. Oh, it's like right out of the fridge, but yes. All right, so let's dig in. I have my plate of pasta down here, my noodles. I don't even know what, actually, let's do the chicken first. We want this really crunchy. Are you ready for it? Ooh, that's still hot. That's good. Okay. Oh my God, yeah. I'm doing the napkin dance. Don't you do that too? Where's the napkins? Do 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 do. Where's the chapstick? Where's the napkins? I have so much food, it doesn't even all fit. Oh my God, I have all these fries. And I have biscuits, but the biscuits can stay over there. You know, they make your mouth really dry. They're full of calories. I'll add them with cheese when I want to have a midnight snack. Okay, here are some french fries I can enjoy. Oh yeah. I'm the pickiest french fry eater in the world. These are good. You know why? The reason I'm picky is because I like seasoned stuff. I'm gonna be nice and neat, okay? Uh-oh, here comes the loud music. My neighbors. It's not Friday, I swear. What day is it? Here, let's do this crunchy one. Here, are you ready for it? These neighbors. Bam! This is a better direction. Not one direction. This is the direction. A direction. There goes that neighbor again. He's in his car. He's traveling all the way up. That's good. I don't know which one the spicy is. I want that spice. Maybe this one. This one looks like it could be spicy. That's good though. I'm actually really happy. It doesn't taste spicy though. But I'm happy because last time I ate here, everything was dry. And then, when you eat a breast, it's dry. Chicken. Chicken breast. I'm adding my own spice. Stop, up.
I'm happy. This is good. I'm actually happy. How are you today? How are you today? That's what I say. Oh my god. I'm about to try my deep fried shrimp. So I got ranch, ketchup. Oh, we're gonna do mustard. We're gonna do honey. Honey.
We're gonna do hot sauce. This is blueberry sauce. Grape jelly. Well, we'll do that too. They gave me everything. Wow, good job. Good job, Postmates lady. All right, let's first do honey. Honey, 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 honey. All right, let's get a piece. Let's do the one I was being eaten out of. Are you ready? Ooh, this is going everywhere. That's okay. More the merrier. That's a bone. Hold on. When you go out on a date at Popeye's, well, I don't know. Do you go on Popeye's dates? If you do, how do you get the bones out your mouth romantically? You know what I mean? All right, let's try the ranch. Oh, I know what ranch. What is with this rib jug? Let's do hot sauce. No, that's honey. Hot sauce. Oh, I'm sweating from the spice. I'm like, why am I sweating today? It's the spice. And I'm just gonna add more. Spice it up. This makes me think of when I did my giant Takis video. All right, spicy. Ooh, ow. Ooh. Let's cool it down with some honey on top of it. That's a good combo. Honey, hot sauce. Okay. I'm sorry, I'm chewing with my mouth open. It's only because it's hot. I'm sweating, hot and steamy. I like to get all the pieces off the bone. So, yeah, Orland's gone. That's why the house is all quiet. But then again, he sometimes falls asleep. Like yesterday, he fell asleep right behind the camera. Okay, that one's dry. That's actually perfect. Do I get like tartar sauce or something with my deep fried shrimpies? No, I didn't. Everything in here is ketchup. Let's do more hot sauce. That was actually really nice. I actually like that. Hot and steamy. I did not sleep good last night because 2 days ago there was an airplane crash. And we're not going to talk about what we're eating. We don't we'll have upset feelings over here. But are you guys the same way as me when something tragic happens? You go on Twitter and you just watch Twitter and keep refreshing for hours till the next development is announced. Like, I will never forget, I was in Colombia, I had just finished my YouNow session, live streaming,
And that's when I went on Twitter. I was right to go to sleep. I was literally about to go to sleep. I'm like, okay, it's 2 a.m. Yawn, 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 yawn. And that's when I learned about the Las Vegas shooting. Oh, I didn't sleep at all that night. I remember, I couldn't believe what I was seeing and hearing.
These fries are good.
Let's open up some ranch. I'm happy with these fries. Excuse me. But just because I don't want to, you know, I don't want to scare you guys, but I'm just going to say real quick and then we'll stop talking about the subject. I care about my sloths. I want you to live. Do not go on an airplane that's called MAX 8. That's all you got to know. Boeing MAX 8. They have, right now, American Airlines, United, and Southwest are still using them despite the crashes. And that makes me, like, why? They make billions. Come on. I was going to purchase my trip to Los Angeles tonight or tomorrow. Guess who's taking Delta? Me. Because they don't use this model that's crashed 2 times in a row, back to back, killing all people. And it's not the fact that it crashed. I'm sorry, kids. This is very scary. It's the way that it crashed. Nose dive, head first, at extreme acceleration. Both times. In Indonesia, on Lion Air, now in Ethiopia. That's not normal. And back to back on brand new. Yeah, we're gonna stop talking about this. Oh, I have to open this one. Ha, yeah. That really distressed, that, ugh. God, distressed me. You guys know, me and airplanes. But I'm gonna take Delta and hopefully that's okay. Have you ever put honey on shrimp before? That's actually really good. Sweet and sour sauce? No. I'm just liking the hot sauce. I'm liking the heat. Oh, I still have all this chicken here. Let's add more. Let's do more hot sauce. So please check. I would not even fly with American, United, or Southwest until they take them off. China just did. I said I was going to stop talking about dinner. I'm sorry. We're eating. I know it's very sad, but I just, a lot of people don't even know. I have a lot of people who watch YouTube that don't watch TV. They don't even know this is happening. I was reading some posts by pilots on Twitter who said, I'm uncomfortable flying it. Pilots. Cartilage. I like it with hot sauce now. These fries would be great with cheese. This would be a good cheese fry because these are nice and seasoned. That McDonald's one that I did yesterday was great, but had I only added mozzarella cheese and American cheese and not put on the, basically it's ketchup and mayonnaise, it's the animal style fry from the sauce from In-N-Out. Had I not put that on to give it moisture, they would have been disgusting. McDonald's fries, you have to eat right away. Right away. Good, good, good. I used all the hot sauce. Wow. I don't know which one's spicy. I know this is, people don't like when I do this, but I'm going to. None of them look spicy to me. Maybe this one? That's good. It's not spicy. I think the lady forgot, but that's okay. I'm gonna add some honey. Let's put some Cheeto dust on it. That is a good combination. Oh my god, that is a good combination. We're gonna do a little ranch bit. I think I just ruined it. Oh my god, I love ranch. What am I talking about? I want to curse so badly. This is actually really beep, beep, beep good. Oh my God. When I have, this tastes like KFC to me. That's the thing.
This doesn't even have that Popeyes flavor.
I'm telling you, fast food around here is very different than Pennsylvania. If I close my eyes, this would be KFC, and I can usually tell them apart very easily, because the batter on Popeyes has a very distinctive flavor. I can taste it in the shrimp, but not the chicken. This looks like KFC.
It tastes like KFC. It's so greasy. Popeyes has always been drier to me. Oh my God, I love this bottle. My mouth is on fire from the spice, and now it's just really cooled it down. Life is good. Ooh, I'm so naughty. Like, look at the junk I eat. I love my life. This is kind of gross too, because the silverware gets all nasty, but that's okay. I want to put hot sauce. There has to be more hot sauce. Yes, there is. Hot sauce on my Alfredo. Here we go.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. Was that a bunch of bones? I can't tell. Maybe. I'm impressed. Well, I hope you guys are having a great day. I feel like I'm doing a mukbang and chill today. Yesterday was chill too. You guys are like, yeah, thank God. All you do is run your mouth, Nick. Finally, we're doing a real mukbang where you do casual snippets, but mostly devour. Oh, I want to bring something up to you guys. Oh, spicy sauce on my fingers. You know, I brought up the Fraxel. I want like a thing for my face to make it. I know. I don't really need it, but it's a preventive thing. By the way, no. I blur out my face. It's focused right here. So the depth of field, I'm all the way back here. Look how far my hand has to go. My face looks really good right now because it's blurred out. And if you think it looks bad, well, honey, let's just focus on the face and then you'll see what I really look like. I have bumps. I have acne scars. I have scars from when I had chicken pox that I got when I was a kid, an adult kid. I was in like high school or college, I forget. Oh, this is about to die, hold on. And I'm back from turning the camera back on. what was I gonna say? Oh, yes. So a few mukbangs back, maybe a week ago, I had brought up something to like, you know, because if you have scars, wrinkles, sun pigmentation problems, that's a big thing I have on my forehead, my cheeks, because I did tanning a lot when I was vegan and I so regret it. I want to look like baby butt white for the rest of my life. Like, I don't know what I was thinking. I'm not attracted to like tan bodies anymore. I used to really be into them. I used to hate myself. I'm like, ew, I'm so white. Now it's like, no, that's wrinkles that are gonna come real fast. Irreversible skin damage, Nick. Why? You know, why would I do that? If you naturally have dark skin, well, lucky you. If you naturally have white skin, embrace it. It's so funny because people in Thailand, a lot, I noticed they were doing the opposite very often. Not all of them, but a lot of people advertised everywhere to whiten your skin bleaching. Anyways, embrace how God made you, but take care of your skin nonetheless. I didn't really wear sunscreen ever on my face. That's actually getting better and better. The more I eat, the more I like it. I'm definitely not like yesterday's video. That was orgasmic. Yeah.
But that's very good. So there's, you know, there's something called a Fraxel, which is red lasers that penetrate your skin. It hurts like a mother. Oh my God, I went on forums. People telling how awful, it's worse than tattoos and child labor pregnancy put together. People are saying the pain. And you have to sit there awake. And that's after the numbing cream and the narcotic or whatever they give you to knock you out. You have to be awake for it. You're a little loopy. And it's so much pain. They give you these stress balls to squeeze during the procedure. I could never. If I get a paper cut, I want to pass out. So I want this procedure. Something for myself, you know. But I don't want to be in pain. There's no way I could. There's no possible way. And to get the wow factor, you have to have two Fraxels. By the way, the recovery, you get swollen like a bumblebee. You look like a tomato. You're all red. Everything hurts. You're basically killing your skin cells and letting the new ones come out. And there's like a long downtime, like 2 weeks of downtime. Listen, I film daily. Do you want me to look like a pumpkin? First of all, you won't be even able to open your mouth. You'd be like this, blah, 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 blah. So the point of the story is they have something called a baby Fraxel, which is called Clear and Brilliant. And that's a 1 day downtime, no pain at all. You just have to do more than them. You have to do like six to get the two. So every three, Clear and Brilliant equals one Fraxel. Well, it depends who you talk to. Some people say more. Some people say it's not possible, but I've read enough and talked to enough. I've been calling different dermatologists and they said, no, you'll get the same effect. You just have to be consistent and be willing to come back over and over and over and over. But it's gonna peel away that skin, make your scars go away, make that pigmentation smoother. So, I'm gonna do this, but I'm gonna do it in May. Because this April, I'm going to Los Angeles, you guys know. I'm buying my tickets tonight or tomorrow, like I said. And yes, I have the people picked out. And it's really sad because I have more people now messaging me. Can we clap? Can we clap? I'm like, I can't physically, because remember, a video for me and a video for you. I already have 5 people. These are such big meals, I can only film once a day. I can't do 2 a day for 2 weeks. That is literally auditioning for Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead. You know that movie? I can only film once a day. And they get a day, and I get a day. I've committed to 5 people, that's already 10 days minimum, not counting travel days. So I'm looking at 2 weeks. And I'm gonna be every single day. Is that too much? I don't think so. It's worth it. If I'm going all the way there, and I hate flying, collab with lots of YouTubers. There's one in particular that this trip was really inspired for. And she lives there, and so we're doing 2 for her and 2 for me, because not to downplay the others, but she was the first one. She's also mukbang, it makes sense, we do the same thing. Some of these other people, they do mukbangs, but they do other stuff. Listen, I can't spread myself too thin, you know. I feel bad. They're eventually gonna find out, why did he do 2 with her, but not 2 with me? Because every day I have to pay for hotel. Every day is, you know, I'm doing the best I can. I don't know. I tell myself, people feel upset that I only did 1 video with them. I said, because that's the type of person I am. I feel bad. I don't want to make people feel bad. And Orland said, Nick, no, because 1 video is better than 0. They're lucky that you're willing to pay $1,000, go all the way there, spend $1,000 in hotels and Ubers, pay thousands of dollars to bring them on your channel, you know? They're happy to be with you, even if it's just 1 time. It's better than 0. So I guess if I think of it that way, I just hope they don't. I don't think, but you never know. You know, people get jealous, and I've been jealous about people before. Like, why did she get more than 1 video, you know? And now that I do YouTube, I'm like, oh, yeah, this makes sense. So I'm not picking favorites. I'm spreading myself real thin. I did a bunch with Carly because I stayed there for a week and I only stayed with her. I did brunch with Candy because I stayed there for 10 days during a visa run. I didn't know anyone in Las Vegas. So I filmed with her every day pretty much. Obviously, I spread those videos out, but you know what I mean? Now I'm going to Los Angeles and there's 5 people already that I'm committed to. I can't stay there for a month. So I'm spreading myself out to get more variation of people, which I think is for the better. I just hope, because there's one of them that I'm doing 2 with, which I'm really excited for. But I hope that the other collabs don't be like, oh, why did he do 2 with me? I don't know. Maybe they're watching this. Is this petty? No, I feel like I'd be mature about it. I'm letting people know. Don't hate me for it, please. I'm like thinking ahead. What else do I want? This shrimp's good. I do wish, however, they gave me some kind of fish sauce, tartar sauce, cocktail sauce. Oh, here's all my napkins. I was like, using these paper towels. I'm not gonna keep using these paper towels to have napkins here. I'm sweating from all this spice. Ooh, there's more hot sauce. Oh no, this is honey. Let's do honey on, well, let's finish this leg. Hopefully you guys are excited. I promise I'll stop talking about it now. I won't even talk about it till I'm there, okay? I spent 4 videos in a row saying, I'm going to LA. I'm going to LA. Maybe more than that. Oh, that was a surprising crunch. What was that? Do you ever eat chicken and be like, what's this? What's this part? What's this? What's this part over here? Crunch, crunch. What's that part? They're just eating all. This is a lot of shrimpies.
I'm good. Oh my god, I'm sweating so much. I actually really like this combo. The pasta is getting dry now.
Do you know real Alfredo is supposed to be? Just like carbonara. It's not supposed to be creamy and rich. It's supposed to be like mostly dry.
Mmm, that's fine.
It looks a lot drier than it is. Getting full. This is a great meal though. That's a good combo.
I love ranch. You can't get sick of it.
Even if it's something that's not supposed to go in ranch, it still tastes good. I'm gonna save these pieces, which I haven't touched, well, a bit into, excuse me, for later. I'm gonna take the bones out, chop it up, shred it up, and put it in my breakfast burritos. Ugh. Actually, no. I don't know how to make that. Okay, I put it in the fridge, and Orly makes it for me when he comes back, because he loves to do that for me. Oh, he's so cute. Because he doesn't eat a lot of this food. And he's like a lot of you guys. He gets pleasure out of watching me eat stuff he's not allowed to eat. He'll literally sit in the kitchen and be like this to me. Watching like a dog. And I'm like doing a show for him. I'm like, oh, baby, it's so good. Oh, that hot sauce. Mmm, it's greasy. Oh, I'm so happy. He's over here literally like, because he can't eat it, but he gets joy out of watching me enjoy it. He's just like a lot of you. Oh. It's really not that hot in here. It's just I'm sweating from the spice. The shrimp is delicious. Mmm. What's this? And no, I didn't touch my biscuits. I know they're there. I know they're there. I'm doing all shady. I know they're there. Yeah, those biscuits need butter and a lot of it. Those biscuits would be great dunked in beloved sauce. Oh my god. I love her sauce. It's so buttery. And unfortunately, if you do it like the healthier way with chicken stock or water, it's just not the same. You just have to have beloved sauce and do it like 3 times. Dunk, 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 you're done. It's like one of those like saltless 50% less fat chips. They're not even worth eating. If you really care about all that fat and sodium, have it 2 handfuls of chips and stop. The problem is if you really like something, you can't stop. And sometimes you don't feel how upset your body is until an hour during the digestion. And you're like, oh, shoot. Oh, kill me now. And you're on the couch and you can't get up. That's how I feel with her sauce. I love her sauce. It's just I eat way too much because I like to eat till I'm stuffed. And it's just, all that butter. I get so sick. But the flavor is just, oh. It's like a dessert. You know desserts? I mean, I don't eat desserts, but to me, her sauce is my dessert. It's like so bad and so good. You're only supposed to have 1 slice of cake. If you indulge, you have 2. If you don't give a F, you eat half the cake and then you pay for it later. That's her sauce. Oh, but it's so good. But yeah, the chicken would be good. Everything would be good. There. She puts turkey legs in there. I know, I had them. Had those big old turkey legs. Here's my plate. This is just like cartilage. Ooh. I'm full though. Oh my god, I'm so full. I want one more Cheeto. The Cheetos were great. Oh. I'm very happy. Happy and you know it. See what I mean? I'm full, yet I want that spicy stimulation. Like beloved sauce, it's so spicy. Lord Jesus, help me. I could eat this whole bag. 1,300 calories if I eat the whole bag. Of the day's worth of calories. For a small person. For me, girl, that's my breakfast. I eat like 3,000 to 4,000 a day, every day. It's amazing, I don't know how. I'm one of those people too that I'd rather not eat at all until I feast than snack on like 200 calories, like a cracker or no, a granola bar. Because that activates my stomach. I'm so used to such volume. My blood sugar goes all over the place. It's better if I just not skip the meal, but just put the calories in one big go. And then instead of eating a granola bar or something, I'd rather have like collard greens and kale and spinach with lime. Lemon. Oh, people always get mad at me because I'm like, squeeze the lime, squeeze the lime. No, the lemon. What's it called? Lemon? Lemon? Lime? Lemon? One of the two. If I'm holding limes, I say lemon. If I'm holding lemon, I say lime. Something like that. And people are like, Nick, you're saying the wrong thing. I'm getting really upset. It's because when I lived in Colombia, they had the same word for both. And I lived there for a few years. And so I'm used to, and I hear Orlan be like, lemon or lime. What does he say? Is that lemon or lime? Probably lemon. That sounds French. I don't even know. Lemons and limes are different to us. In Colombia, they're the same thing. Especially the part we were in. So I'm just, I know the difference. Lemons are yellow. They are juicier and larger. However, they have more seeds and they're more annoying to squirt because the seeds fly out. Limes are better because they have no seeds virtually, but they also have a stronger flavor, but they're smaller and less water. Pick your poison. I don't know. Yeah, they call them the same thing. They'd be like, I want a lime yellow or a lime green. They go to the grocery store. One more, because I really want to sleep good tonight. I didn't sleep good last night because of that airplane. I tossed and turned all night with nightmares. Seriously. And my secret is eat a lot of food so it knocks you out and you don't wake up for a long, long time. Hopefully you do wake up. That sounds awful. I'm eating really messy today. I'm sorry. Chewing with my mouth open, you guys know I never do that. I don't know why I'm doing it. I am. I think it's because of that spice. It like, I'm panting. What else do I wanna? If you wanna try. I'm back home, shooby-doo. Wouldn't that be a fun music video? I know I said that in someone's collab. I'm like, I want all us American mukbangers to get together and we'll do a music video. I guess it'll be for my channel because it's I'm Back Home, shooby-doo, and that's my song. I would pay them. Everyone gets $200 or something. So for your time. We spend a couple hours filming and shooting the music video, and they all go to the recording studio and sing their part. We have different voices. I already said this story. But keep people, I see that in the comments a lot. Nick, make your own music video with all the mukbangers and you in the center. I'm back home, shooby-doo, and we have B-Loves. Hello, shwap, shwap. And we have Steph over here. Hello, hello, shwap, shooby-doo. Well, all the American mukbangers that don't dislike me. Actually, all the American ones like me. Veronica's Canadian. All the American ones like me, I think. I don't know. Who knows? Would they do it? That's the thing, like. If I pay them, they might. I don't know. It'll be fun. I don't know. Oh, I'm stuffing it in, but I want to sleep good. I wanna sleep good. I'm in a very singing mood today. Let's put these in the ranch. Let's do it.
Mmm. Does Popeyes even have tartar sauce and cocktail sauce? Do you know?
Because I want to know. Oh God, that's my cue to stop. I want this to be cereal. I want to eat myself to a coma, please. I didn't sleep. I want to be knocked out. I'm so tired.
People are gonna take clips of this.
Where I'm saying I want to be knocked out where I don't wake up. It's like, Nikocado's promoting unhealthy habits.
Ow!
That's a big bus. Oh, I am gonna fall asleep right about now. I'm happy. Please don't take this out of context. I'm making myself pass out on purpose because I slept for like 4 hours and I'm exhausted. And this is my way of making sure I stay asleep. Actually, carbs in general. Even if I just ate the chicken, that wouldn't have been enough. I need that carb. The carb makes you sleep longer. Carbs. I was just staring at the camera. I have 60 seconds left. Bye. Hey, this got real piggish at the end. I'm so sorry. I'm just tired.
Carbs, yeah.
Let me eat these carbs. But before I sleep, I'm gonna have some collard greens and some spinach or something. Kale.
Fiber.
Ew.
Oh my God.
Bye. Eat my Cheeto.